Thanks for joining us tonight at 11, everybody. I'm Abby Walton.
And I'm Zach Dahlheimer. Earlier today, city commissioners got an update on changes coming next week.
Our Brea Ruffin tells us what's being done and what the student's family is telling city leaders.
Ellie Sims was hit and killed nearly 2 months ago while using a crosswalk on FSU's campus along West Pensacola Street. On Wednesday, her parents traveled hundreds of miles to petition for the safety of students on college campuses.
I wish you could have met her. She was awesome.
Ellie's parents, John and Kristen Sims, spoke out Wednesday, thanking the city for putting a plan in place to target speeders and protect pedestrians. Some of those measures include 9 new speed tables, flashing lights at crosswalks, and raised intersections. Ellie's dad says no other family should have to suffer a loss like this one, and he questions why these rules weren't set in place from the beginning.
Why wasn't there consideration given to the amount of pressure, that foot traffic, that increased number of pedestrians who are going to be crossing a very, very busy road in Pensacola?
Sim says that his family is forever changed, a hole that can never be filled without their Ellie.
The plan that the council has come up with really is going to be it will make a difference, and I believe that it would have protected Ellie. But all of those things could have been done beforehand.
The next step for the Sims family is to push for traffic lights at these crosswalks on campus. And Ellie's family shared with me that they are still carrying their grief with them every single day, but they also carry Ellie's smile and her spirit with them as well. Reporting in Tallahassee, Brea Ruffin, WCTV Eyewitness News.
And in memory of Sims, her sorority, Alpha Chi Omega, partnered with her family to establish a memorial fund.